I know my way.
Welcome to Hotel Krat. This is a supply box officially approved by the city of Krat. I shall open it and add it to the hotel shop. Many thanks, good sir. Welcome to Hotel Krat.
damn it!
I can't find the way out. Monsters everywhere. I need to grab my share and leave. Oh. Well, that's odd. I thought I was the only one with a sound mind here. Sure, I don't need to introduce myself. Note these golden wings. Yes, you guessed it. You don't know who I am. Preposterous! Everyone in Krat has heard of me. Do you live under a rock? I'm Alidoro the Hound. Treasure hunter extraordinaire. Yes, it's a nickname. I ditched my real name in the past. I'm looking for other survivors of this disaster, but it's been a lonely search, and there's danger around every corner. Do you know of a place where I can take refuge? Preferably someplace clean and comfortable, you know, civilized. Vanini Works? I didn't give that place much thought. That's where the puppets are being made, after all. But I heard tell of a shelter there as well. With no first-hand knowledge, I suppose I have to trust you. I have a lot of searching ahead of me, so why don't I lighten my load? Consider this an act of charity. A thank you gift. Take it. Since you're so helpful, I'll give you a peek at my collection. Show me what you're worthy of. As a descendant of aristocrats, the very best families, I have a duty to the common people. I live my life fulfilling that duty. And part of that duty is ensuring these items are returned to their rightful owners. What I'm showing you is just a portion of the collection. If you come to the refuge, we'll be able to continue our confabulation. Until then, remember this hound when golden wings shine.
And now, the stage is set.
I want to go back to the old Krat, the old me, before the greed overtook me.
You? I didn't think we'd ever meet again. Can't say I'm happy to see you, though. Sorry, I let my frustration get the better of me. This place is crawling with hostile puppets. You must have known that, but you still sent me here. Honor and trust are everything to this hound. You've insulted me to the core. I'll never forgive you. But perhaps there's a shred of decency in you? So I'll ask again. Do you know of a safe place? You see? This is how we rebuild trust, you and I. I'll take another chance on you. I'm nothing if not magnanimous, you see? But beware. A hound's teeth are sharper than a sword. One bite is enough to take your life. You tricked me with your lie. You disappoint me. But I'm no stranger to beneficence, so I shall let it pass one more time. Know that even my forgiveness has its limits. Remember, the hound's fangs crave the traitor's neck. You tricked me.
But
remember. Oh, it's you. This hotel is indeed a refuge from the dangers of the outside world. I am the Hound, a descendant of the city's most aristocratic families. Repaying debts is what we nobles do. Anyone with a worthy spirit is especially welcome. Accordingly, I shall give you the honor of laying eyes upon my treasure. However, you must prove your worthiness. For this legendary treasure, the ego of a powerful enemy shall suffice. It's up to you if you want to make the exchange. Take your time to admire it. I've certainly done likewise.
Have no idea so many
thanks for keep.
I see you're here. That means you can lie. Your lies are a rare ability. People on the I see you.
That book reminds me. Have you ever heard the fairy tale about a mischievous wooden puppet? All of Krat knows the story, all because of someone who loved that story more than anyone else. But this is strange. I do not recall who exactly was that someone.
You know that stalker? The Hound? Is it true you brought him here? Wow! I didn't know he was still alive! Thank heavens! I haven't seen him in person, and I don't know how I'd react. How do you thank the man who saved your life? I'm so glad that someone so kind has reached safety. And speaking of safety, please take care of yourself out there. You're not the only one who's curious. Most people get around to asking where I'm from. My looks give it away, don't they? Suffice it to say, I'm from the country of the morning, beyond the ocean. But I wouldn't be much of a tour guide. All I know about it is their weapons. My family was a house of weapons specialists. It's quite a reputation to live up to. They almost took charge of planning for the grand exhibition. But that's their reputation, not mine. And they deserted me when I was little. I don't even know who they are. And my reputation is my own. I suppose my only connection to them would be weapons. So I'm an orphan, and that hardly makes me exotic in Krat. Can I help you with anything else? I know my way.
The cathedral. Maybe those who went there seeking refuge became monsters somehow. But the petrification disease turns you to stone, not into a monster. I'm worried about the Malam district, just below the cathedral. I wonder whether there are monsters there, too. You're full of surprise.
Change is never easy. Look at me. A human trapped in the shackles of the past. I wish I was back in Krat before the petrification disease. Before the disaster. Krat was a city of light. A city of joy. I wish I could go back, even just for one day.
I know my way.
I've been investigating the puppet frenzy, and it looks like I need your help. First, let me show you a little something I've been working on. I call it the Ergo Wavelength Decoder. The name lacks a certain flair, but I assure you it works. If my suspicions are correct, something in the puppet's very ergo is causing their aggression. My decoder can find malicious signals within the waves, but I cannot possibly get close enough to gather the ergo wave records myself. You, on the other hand, would you? Could you? I refuse to believe the King of Puppets is truly behind this puppet rampage. It's too simple, but also a bit too much even for him. No. I suspect the ergo itself is corrupted, or at least compromised. I do so desperately want to find the cause, as I'm sure you do too, my friend. It breaks my heart to see puppets turned into murderous tools of bloodshed. I always welcome friends.
Once, Krat was just a small town on the coast of little importance. Before Elysian Boulevard was built, this place literally was all there was of Krat. But when some in the city prospered, they left the old town behind. Through isolation and neglect, Krat's first incarnation became nothing but dangerous alleys and desperate slums. Bright side, I guess. The whole city of Krat's pretty much like that now. The old town caught up with the new. It's true what they say. A receding tide sinks all boats.